And that return of the fumble is the third longest in Oklahoma history. They're saying officially 61 yards. Hartley to kick it off, Hill and Gordon. We'll see if he had a little bit of a breeze kicking the other way, because the last one, or the last two, have been about 5 and then 9 yards deep. This one's not going to make it into the end zone. Gordon. And Gordon will be stopped at the 20-yard line. And let's go down to the sideline, Jimmy Dykes.
Well, Ron, you know Javaris James, with his head on the sidelines right now, is thinking, what should I have done differently in that ball game? I actually spoke with Edgren James yesterday afternoon on the phone. He called me, and we talked for about 15 minutes. And he said his advice to Javaris James, he said, I will tell him, stick with the fundamentals in a big game atmosphere. Don't play too fast. Don't let your emotions get the best of you. Stick with your vision and stick with your timing, but do not play too fast. He also went on to say that the Edgren's goal is to play someday in the NFL with Javaris. Baby J, he says, is his number one guy. You know, he wishes you could talk to him right now.
Boy, that's for sure. Pass is thrown incomplete. Austin English was really applying pressure on the quarterback, Freeman. Darnell Jenkins is the man they were looking for, but incomplete.
Go back to the history of this series, Ron. I was just getting started at the University of Washington when these teams locked horns in 85, 86, and 87. And everyone in the country as players watched those games and just saw the difference in speed at Miami. And really, University of Washington, we changed our whole focus, went to speed, and ended up winning a national championship because of that change. They really altered the game.
Cooper, right up the middle, will weave his way for about 3 yards.
If you focus in on the national championships, there's a lot of fans here that think Oklahoma would have 9, maybe 10, if it weren't for Miami. In that 3-year stretch between 85 and 87, Oklahoma went 33-3. And those 3 losses were against all against Miami. So there's still a lot of hurt feelings in this building about those mid-80s games.
Third down, they need the 30-yard line. Pumped it once, now going to go long. Single coverage, and the ball is overthrown and incomplete. DJ Wolf was the man with the cover on Lance Leggett, and Leggett has just not been able to get free today. They've been all over him.
Well, the only way that they're going to be able to get free, Ron, is to be able to get the running game going. I don't think that Kirby Freeman is going to be able to beat Oklahoma with his arm alone. They're going to need some type of run game first, second down, so that Oklahoma doesn't know exactly what they're doing on third.
Bosher into punt. Fourth time that he will have kicked today. Back deep, number 3, Reggie Smith. Very high, and again it is short. And the ball is caught at the 40-yard line of Oklahoma. Well, let's take a look at the 1988 Orange Bowl, Miami against Oklahoma. In fact, we pick up action in the third quarter. Steve Walsh throwing to Michael Irvin for 23 yards and a touchdown pass. This put Miami up 20-7. Then late in the fourth quarter, Oklahoma runs a fumble rooski. And that's offensive lineman Mark Hudson. He'll take it in from the 29, but Miami was still up 20-14, and that was the final score. From 1985 to 1987, as Ed said, OU lost just 3 games, and all of those came at the hands of Miami as the pass is thrown complete to the 45, and the ball has come loose. Joaquin Iglesias was the intended receiver.
Well, that's exactly what Miami needed at this time. The momentum had totally turned. Excellent throw by Bradford, and Iglesias does not lock this thing away. The defensive backs get in there and start pulling with it. Excellent job. That's Randy Phillips, who got beat earlier on a touchdown by Kelly, making up for it. Way to finish the play. Got his hand up underneath of it, Ron. You don't see that a lot. The ball is not as protected underneath, and Phillips was able to reach up underneath and pull that thing down. Excellent job by the cornerback.
Well, that receiver was not upon the ball. The coaches were having a fit, said we don't have enough men on the line of scrimmage. And that tackle made by John Williams, who caused that fumble, and the Reggie Smith return of 61 yards for a touchdown. John is having himself a very good day.
And John Williams,
fact, they said yesterday, yep, that if he really comes alive, that this is going to be a really good Oklahoma defense.
And he's a guy who battled a lot, Ron. He blew out his knee, game 1 of 05. Last year was in the hospital for 3 weeks with an infection. He's finally getting his shot as a senior and making the most of it.
Handoff goes to Cooper. They try to sweep it to the right. Nothing doing. Oklahoma right there, and they will lose two more yards. Matt Weiner, let's check back with you in New York.
All right, Ron, Sports Center in game. You'll see Nebraska and USC on ABC primetime next week. The Cornhuskers have a bigger issue right now. They trail at Wake Forest. Brett Hodges to Kevin Marion, who's lucky he only lost it at the one. Demon Deacons would punch it in three plays later. Ohio State, by the way, a couple of turnovers, but they are on the board and lead Akron 3-2.
All righty, thanks very much. Jim Grobe has just done a wonderful job at Wake Forest. They are a for real program under him now. They set up the screen, got blockers in front. This is James, and a nice job defensively by Lewis Baker. Miami is 0 of 6 in third down conversions today. Wow.
Well, and it's the speed of this defense. Lewis Baker at about 210 pounds, more of a strong safety than a Sam linebacker. Ron, that play was done. It looked like it was going to be a first down. They had linemen out there, and Baker trails from the backside linebacker position, closes, and makes the tackle.
So they get a turnover, but are unable to do a thing with it. They only pick up 2 yards, and here's the boot. Not very long again. Fair catch called for and made at the 18-yard line. So we'll take a timeout. 21-3, Oklahoma. You're watching ESPN on ABC.
Well, on ABC, brought to you by...